Hello friends, welcome back, welcome to the new members. Today I am going to discuss something about carrier and embedded systems, although I discussed it earlier as well, but some students wanted it again with respect to the latest developments in the technology. So let me try to attempt it. So as per my understanding, embedded carrier is the entry gate to anything which makes a machine intelligent using electronics. Embedded system is a combination of hardware and software for a particular application. If one can understand the concept of embedded system, it will be not difficult for that person to understand CPU based general purpose platform, that is PC. So here I mean understanding of embedded system up to the level where person understand various high level interfaces, PCI Express, SerDes, TDR, cache, those kind of thing, then he can move up to the level of PC. So embedded systems are being used in our daily life for many years. Let's look into that. Do you remember when you started hearing word automatic gear in car, semi or fully automatic machine, washing machine, automated teller machine, that is called ATM machine we use, automatic toll system, etc. So who was doing that manual job here? Embedded system. So if you go to ATM machine, who is doing that manual job of the bank clerk there? Embedded system. Now, few years back, another term was coined, smart. This initiated another set of embedded system applications. You have a smart energy meter, a smart watch, a smart cricket bat, a smart keychain, a smart board, a smart TV, and a long list. So here, embedded system converted normal things around us to smart things. Further, with the availability of internet everywhere at lower cost, IoT came into the picture. But before I discuss that, let's look into another domain of embedded system, that is automotive. So the main functionality such as engine control, meters, chassis, safety, airbags, car audio, car body, etc. are based on ECU, and there may be more than 100 ECUs in a luxury car, while in normal a handful of them. Here ECU stands for electronic control unit, which is again an embedded system to control electrical subsystem in a car. So in a single car there may be multiple MCUs, microcontrollers, used for this purpose, whether it is a body cluster or, you know, car infotainment or those kind of thing. And now with the availability of internet, this IoT is converting buildings, neighborhood, city, or in fact whole world to smart. So one of the critical requirement of IoT based system is security of data. So this led to the concept of secure boot, and the need of framework for integrating cloud services with IoT-enabled network in a secure way. Application programmers need to just use API for accessing the services. There where people use Python script to, you know, enable such services with that framework. And with the increased trend of open source software, reduction of memory, silicon devices, it is possible to build embedded system with RTOS or any other OS at reasonable cost. For example, Raspberry Pi. And the moment OS is supported for any system, hardware management responsibility goes to OS itself. And user application just use system APIs to access the same. But for a smaller application, for example, you can use MCU even for simple air conditioner unit control or HVAC kind of stuff, and where MCU simply detects or decode that signal from remote and work in different modes, sleep mode, and keep track of different temperature ranges, different programs, those kind of things. So there you don't need OS. You have to monolithic program there and take care of the complete hardware stuff. So the future of IoT is artificial intelligence. So embedded system professionals can easily adopt AI system machine, as that will be also a computing device. So AI basically simulates human brain. So what is artificial intelligence? It simulates the human brain. In that, similar to human being, AI system has to learn from the data received, training received, apply its knowledge or algorithms for model training, and predict the outcome, correct or upgrade the knowledge base. This, you may take analogy. If you learn car, so the trainer will provide you initial rules and all that, then you apply those rules, that training, and under trainer control, then he, help you to rectify your mistakes. So once you are a trained driver, then going further, you will be learning yourself based on your experience, based on your driving experience. You will learn certain things yourself. So similar thing happens with the AI. So this is different from the earlier automatic stuff, where you put a state machine in that microcontroller and it follows that state machine. This is different from that. Here there is a scope or learning further and rectifying, updating and rectifying the mistakes updating the knowledge base. But here artificial intelligence also depends on your sensors, camera, or where it is, other kind of stuff like audio recognition. So that is being taken care of by embedded again. And who will provide data to a machine learning system? Maybe it is a deep data analysis or whatever. Who will provide data to that system? It will be the IoT and node. Again, the embedded professional will be required there. So you may ask, future is with computer vision, machine learning, why should I learn embedded? I do agree. The next generation is for computer vision, machine learning, artificial intelligence, deep learning, big data, etc. But if you are an electronics engineer, you may make a balance between these two. Let's see the role of embedded here. Did you try face detection with OpenCV, that is the computer vision open source, using Raspberry Pi board? You may create a complete product, but what you will do if your computer introduces a customized low-cost product with the same feature? You must have knowledge to build a customized system. There you need embedded engineer who can work on a low-level driver, board design, bring up and integrate camera module or other sensors. Similarly, one can use MicroPython with OpenMV, that is the machine vision board, for simple, you know, vision specific things, that is, let's say, color tracking and all those kind of stuff. Okay, so what are the other embedded applications? You know, the aerospace, defense, audio, speech, automotive, displays, e-reader, EVM, electronic voting machine, home appliances, intelligent power, Internet of Things, lighting, medical, motor control, networking, security, smart energy, smart metering, smartphone, long list. But where is the job for embedded system engineer? There is no doubt that it takes time to get a job in embedded domain. So it is basically individual choice, efforts and patience. Everyone try for IIT, many students prepare for GATE, and few go further for IAS exams. But how many get selected? Still they do that. So if someone has good academic background and try for embedded career, it should not be that difficult of the level of IIT, GATE or IAS. So there are options for average students as well, but no one can guarantee for job. If you are looking for embedded system job, I can just provide some tips here, some options to hunt for job. So you may look into the key market player. I am listing here the silicon vendor along with their, you know, career portal. You go to my, you know, website embedkari.com, and there you will find this particular article, and from there you can click on these things and directly go to the job portal. And whenever you are hunting for job, just go to this embedded career page, or you can bookmark or whatever, and then you click or there or subscribe. So next time you will get this, you know, on email itself, this particular article. So what are the other options apart from these silicon vendors? So job opportunity in India. So there's some distributor of these silicon vendor as well. And apart from that, companies, you know, companies like ABB for electrical, C-DOT, Cisco, DRDO. So some of them may not be, you know, directly recruiting. They have their own method, but I have given link to that. So you will get that kind of information, you know, what is their process. For example, DRDO, what is the process? And some of these, for example, C-DOT might be conducting their exams, written exams, and DRDO might be based on this GATE score. So that you will come to know from there. But others like Juniper Networks and all that, you can try KPIT directly. You can try what are the current options available. And you will also come to know what kind of, you know, skill set these companies normally ask, and a long list. So some of them, Samsung, Philips, Bajaj Auto, and Bell, Toradex, Whirlpool. Okay, so key areas to focus is microcontroller, microprocessor, DSP, ASIC, core areas, FPGA and embedded system and board design, software development tool, embedded OS, Linux and all those kind of stuff, software testing tools, middleware, long list of middleware related to the field, whatever field you are going to choose, whether it is automotive or networking, it depends. Okay, so thanks for your time, and please subscribe this Embedkari channel. Thanks.